Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Wright. Anitra Ford. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match game 76. And now, here's the star of match game 76.
Thank you, Johnny O. Thank you, friends. Is everyone quite all right? Everyone's healthy and happy?
Yes.
Good. Because diseased people are not allowed on this program. Wait a minute, come back. Yes, ma'am.
Now we've all got it.
Speak for yourself, kid.
What's that? Oh, yes. This pretty face and the rest of her is also seen on The Price is Right daily. If you tune in on CBS in the morning, Anitra Ford.
Come on down.
Okay. Yes, Brett.
Brett is on
what,
The
dear?
Price is Cheap.
The Price.
Someone's stolen my hanky.
You lost your hanky?
Oh, I...
You get you another one. And you?
Oh.
This is a wonderful actress whom you see on the Mary Tyler Moore Show, and she makes an enormous contribution to that program.
Oh.
Yes, here we go.
Does that mean that she pays them to be on it?
No. Greg has a movie coming out sometime in the very near future, right?
Yes, called Countdown at Cosini. In fact, it's on the boards right now.
It is?
Yes.
Okay, look for Greg Morris. And now let's say hello to Darlene Landon and Karen Tripp. Hello, ladies. Now, Darlene's our current champ. This lady has won $5,600, and that puts a big smile on her face. She's a music major. She sings and writes music, and this will enable you to buy a lot of note paper, won't it?
Well, I think I'm going to send my mom on a well-deserved vacation. Yeah.
Really? She's sending her mother out of town. You're going to send her out of town, eh? How far are you sending her?
You know, wherever the needle goes, the thread must follow.
Oh. Oh, I don't know what that means,
but
isn't it philosophical? Do you get the point? I don't get the point. Now, she's going to be challenged. We're going to start a brand new game now with this lady, Karen Tripp, whose face may look familiar to you, and the reason her face does look familiar is she's been on the program before, and she lost. And one of the factors that might have had a bearing on her status here is the fact that the questions got out of order in the machine there. So we thought, in all fairness, we ought to bring her back. And we're going to do that, and we'll start this game right after these messages. Okay. We are ready. Push the button with my magic finger and ask Karen Tripp to make a selection.
A.
A it is. Here we go. If you would please. I have this TV guide listing for you.
Good.
Are you all ready for that?
Mm-hmm.
Sunday night, CBS, Kojak. Kojak gets a big surprise when he discovers that someone has dipped his lollipop in blank. Kojak gets a big surprise. A synopsis of the story in one sentence. Kojak gets a big surprise when he discovers that someone has dipped his lollipop in blank.
I think I know the answer to that.
All right. Okay. Yes.
Music moves me.
It's the only thing is about it, Anitra. When you go home tonight, you won't be able to hum that song. All right, Greg is ready, so we come up to Karen Tripp. TV guide listing, Karen. Sunday night, CBS, Kojak. And the little synopsis of the story is Kojak gets a big surprise when he discovers that someone has dipped his lollipop in blank.
Liquor?
In liquor.
Yeah. Like alcohol liquor.
Yes. Yes. All right. Karen says someone has dipped his lollipop in liquor. What'd you say, Greg?
Lollipop.
Well, it's a new brand of bourbon on my block.
Done.
Gross.
Okay. There's one choice.
Yes, ma'am.
Mine is more melodic.
Melodic?
Melodic. I said, do, do, re, me.
I'll say. Yes.
In honor of our lovely California beaches, Jean, I chose sand.
Sand, yeah.
Ah, you don't like it, then don't watch.
I think he's cracked.
Yes, he is.
Oh.
Lollipop.
I sit on this end and the other end goes up. Yes, Anitra. Kojak gets a big surprise when he discovers someone has dipped his lollipop in, and Karen said, liquor.
Lollipop, lollipop.
Good.
Glue. Yeah. That would surprise him, wouldn't it?
But he couldn't complain.
Yes. Get it out of there.
Ow.
Oh, that would hurt.
Ooh.
Boing.
Ooh.
Oh, 10-5.
That's 10-4. What is
it? Right here, 10-6.
Now, Miss Betty White, honey.
I have a heavy answer.
A heavy answer.
Cement.
Cement.
Whoa.
So, Karen?
Awesome.
Darling, let's see how you do with yours. Remember, the first one's a little tough, so listen carefully. One chicken said to the other chicken, the strangest thing happened to me. I sat in the sun all day yesterday, and today I laid a blank egg.
One chicken said what?
One chicken said to the other, the strangest thing happened to me. I sat in the sun all day yesterday. Today I laid a blank egg.
Oh, I got it.
Got it.
I got it. You know, as I say, I'm not quick. But good. I'm so cute, it doesn't
make
any difference.
Right. You got it?
What?
Have you got it?
I've got it.
I'll say you got it. All right, Charles, we are waiting.
Charles? Oh, Charles is getting worse instead of better. I thought he was going to be like wine. He was going to get better with age, but that's not true.
It's a good thing he's got a hit play on Broadway. All right, Darlene. One chicken said to the other, the strangest thing happened to me. I sat in the sun all day yesterday, and today I laid a blank egg.
A fried egg.
A fried egg? Seems like a reasonable response to me. Does it seem like a reasonable one to you?
Well, see, I figured that this was a chicken in New York in July, you know, which is very hot.
Very hot. It's
very hot.
Yes.
So the egg has to be fried.
Fried egg. Okay, Darlene, one for you. She's looking for a fried egg.
I'd like two over light fried.
Over easy, all right. Would you like to place your order, sir?
Well, I don't think it's possible, but a hard-boiled egg is possible.
Hard-boiled egg is possible.
If you know what I mean.
Hard-boiled. Does that match? No?
Oh. Only the egg part.
Well, then would you make her put her back to two? There she is, back to two again. All right. Anitra. I sat in the sun all day yesterday. Today I laid a blank egg, and Darlene said a fried egg.
Can I have mine sunny side up?
Yes, you can. Fried. Okay. They like two fried eggs. Yes.
Have it at my place if you like. Fried.
Fried. Four for Darlene.
This is the hippest answer.
A hip answer coming up.
This really is. Now you've got to read the question.
The only problem was, this was my other thought. Which was fried.
Yes. Okay. One chicken said to the other, the strangest thing happened to me. I sat in the sun all day yesterday. Today I laid a blank egg.
A brown egg.
A brown egg.
Greg
says she's one of her people.
Well, she's her people.
One of his people. Your
pardon. Betty, I threw that answer out.
I wish I had.
Okay, so there we are. End of round one, scores 4-0, favor the champ. Round two coming up. Hurry right back. Now we're going to round two. Here we go. Bing. A or B, Karen Tripp?
I'll try A again.
A it is for you. And it reads as follows. Everybody plays. Gloria said, I was just at James Bond's house, and he has two ejection seats. One built into his car. I guess I don't even have to read the rest of it then. One built into his car and another built into his blank. All right?
All right, sweetheart.
Good. All right.
I'm standing.
Okay, all set. Let's come over here to Karen Tripp. Did you hear that, Karen? I'll give it to you one more time. Whoops. Oh, whoops. Don't get away from me now.
That's a hot ejection seat.
Yeah. Gloria said I was just at James Bond's house, and he has two ejection seats, one built into his car and another built into his...
toilet.
I didn't hear what she said, honey.
She said toity. Toilet.
Cute.
Yes. Boy. Well, I'm going to hold it, I'll tell you that. I'm not going to... What do you say?
I'm not going to his house.
No, me too. I stay away from them.
No, you know, James Bond was a pretty good swinger.
Yes, he did swing.
Went first class.
Right.
All the way.
All the
so
time.
So I said his deluxe 400-gallon water bed.
A 400-gallon water bed. A water bed. Yes, Brett.
Well, sometimes his mommy came over to visit him.
Yes.
And when he didn't want her to stay all night, he had this little thing bit into his big... terrific, fantastic bed.
Into a bed. Now, Karen, you got two beds so far, and no toity, but you got to match your remaining ones to stay in the game. Charles, we have arrived at your station.
I don't understand both your answers at all. I really mean it.
Toilet seat!
Now, Anitra Ford.
Oh, Doctor, no.
Doctor, no. Doctor, yes, is my name.
Are you ready?
Ready!
For bed?
Bed! Bed! Darlene wins again. Totally in bed. Congratulations once again. Okay. I'll be with you in a moment or so. But right now, we've got to talk to Karen Tripp and thank her for coming back to visit us. It was
thank
a pleasure
you.
Seeing you again. And we've got gifts for Karen Tripp, ladies and gentlemen. And there she goes.
Hello there. I remember you.
Darlene now has added another $100 to her winnings, which puts her at $5,700. She could now win over $5,000 more, put her over $10,000 if she goes all the way here. You ready to try to go all the way?
Yes.
Okay, Darlene. Darlene, look over there. We polled a recent studio audience, Darlene. Are you listening to me, Darlene?
Every word.
Terrific. And we got their best response to this. Soul blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most often is worth $500. If you match it, if you come up with the... second most frequently given response, you get $250. The third gets you $100. All right. You may get an assist from three of our celebrities, one at a time, if you please.
From the Red Devil.
Something we all eat in England.
What's that?
Soul food.
Soul food. Yes. All right. There's
right
one. Answer from the West Boondocks.
Betty. There are so many. I think,
soul drink.
Don't disturb her mind.
I think soul brother.
Soul brother. You got two now.
Got two now.
You need one more.
Need one more.
Yeah. Whom would you call on for the third one?
Brett.
What about soul singer?
Soul singer.
Have you noticed that the show is gradually coming over to all of us, darling?
I knew we'd get you, baby.
So you have soul singer, soul food, and soul brother. Now, you can choose one of those if you want. You're on your own here. You can be on your own if you like and give us one of your own.
Well, my first thought was soul food.
Soul food.
I think
okay.
That's
let's find out if it's up there. And if so, where? Now we'll begin as usual at the bottom, and we will reveal the $100 response. Soul brother. That was Betty's answer. All right. We're looking for a little soul food. Let's see if it's under the $250 number. Soul train. Did you think of that?
Yes.
What is a soul train?
It's a TV show.
Oh, okay.
Okay. All right. Last chance for soul food. She's got her fingers crossed. Let's see if it comes up. Slide it, Earl.
Here it goes.
Soul food. Over 6,000. You got 6,200. Now, Darlene, you've added to your winnings, and you're going to play for 10 times that amount shown up there, or $5,000. Remember, you got to match one celebrity exactly in order to collect.
Dickie Doo.
The Red Devil.
Soul food.
Now, we're past that part of it, Dickie Doo.
Oh.
Yes.
Stand how time the... flies when you're having fun.
Dickie Doo.
I should give her a rap right in the mouth.
All right, here
you
it
will.
Is.
You
yeah.
will.
Shh, shh. It's worth $5,000. Dickie Blank.
This is it.
Dickie Doo. No, I'm sorry. Oh. I was just funning you. This is the real one.
I thought we met.
Ooh. Ready?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Fig blank. F-I-G blank. Fig blank. Okay, Darlene. Now, you think about an answer, and hopefully you're going to think of the same one that he's already written and placed in the slot there. Fig blank.
Newton.
Fig Newton. There are a number of possibilities here, but we're all hoping that Richard has written Fig Newton. What do you say to that, sir?
You know how modest I am.
Yes, of course. Tell us
what
how
did,
modest you
what
are, Dickie
did they Duke. Wear? What did they wear in the Garden of Eden?
Fig leaf. Oh, yes.
No,
what did they eat?
Fig Newtons.
You bet.
Newton! There, everybody's very excited, and while she's cooling off a little bit here, we'll spin these messages for you.
Today's consolation prizes are first an assortment of Sarah Coventry jewelry that you buy from a friend at home, special wardrobe with the money looks of Sarah Coventry fashion jewelry, and from Amity, a lady's three-piece ensemble featuring the ultra French purse, bills easily removed from hidden compartment through the change purse, Amity, and from Kinney Shoes, a great American shoe store, a beautiful selection of fashion footwear. Kinney Shoes are with you every step of the way. As the song goes, you know the rest, and what I like best is doodle-doo-blank. And coming right up, the Match Game 76 continues in a minute.
Okay, I tell you, since we just, we welcome you, Jenny Velasquez, and since we're running close to the end, why don't we just do the question first, and then I'll talk to you as we go along. Are you want A or B?
A, please.
A, Jenny, welcome. Nice to have you with us.
Jenny, that's pretty.
She's a pretty lady. One counterfeiter said to the other, "Hey, stupid, you made a mistake on this $1,000 bill. On the back, there's supposed to be a picture of the White House, not a blank house." One counterfeiter to another.
There's supposed to be a picture of the White House,
not a blank house.
Not a Right.
You're very quick.
Oh, I am.
Yes.
No hablo inglés.
Yes. No hablo inglés?
No hablo inglés.
All right. Good.
Perfectly.
Okay, Brett and Charles, here we go.
Here we go.
Wait a minute. I think I'm gonna just straighten it out a little bit.
All right, now just put it in the slot and stop fooling around.
Well, I'm straight, but you know, sweetheart.
All right, Jenny, you ready? Here we go. One counterfeiter said to the other, "Hey, stupid, you made a mistake on this $1,000 bill. On the back, there's supposed to be a picture of the White House, not a blank house."
Outhouse.
That's one smart player. She came up with the right answer. What do you say?
That's terrible. Outhouse.
One for Jenny. Okay, Brett.
I was going to say black house, but, you know, Greg's with us and all. So I said ill repute house.
Charles?
Hello, dear.
The opposite of in is out.
Right. Anitra. You're on.
This answer is out. Black house.
Yes. Not a picture of the White House. A black house.
Animal lover. I said a cat house.
Jenny's looking for the answer outhouse, Betty.
She found it.
She got an outhouse. Okay. That's three for you. And yours will be along in a moment, but right now, this is especially for you. This is called a fast goodbye.
Goodbye!
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.